hate Miss Michaela.
Yeah.
I don't think they're here.
I think you're...
Oh! They're...
Hi, guys.
Oops, sorry, guys.
Good morning.
Good morning. It's nice to see you again. Mm-hmm. We are happy to be with you guys today.
Yeah. Did you know that Jesus asked us to be like him?
It's true. It says so in the Bible.
But that's okay if you didn't know that, because some of our friends here at AP Kids don't know that either.
Yet. I think that's about to change. So get comfy and come along with us for this week's episode of AP Kids.
Let's get started, shall we?
Okay.
So, what's going on, darling?
Well, it all started Monday morning. I was minding my own business, making a cool tower with some of my blocks that we have, when suddenly I looked over at my little sister, Milana Hope, who was also playing with blocks. But she was building the exact same tower as me. I thought it was kind of weird that she copied me, but I brushed it off and I kept on building.
That doesn't sound too bad.
Just you wait. On Tuesday, I decided that I was going to color one of the coloring pages from our last lesson with Doubting Thomas. And guess what? Milana Hope grabbed this same coloring page. And not only that, but she was using the very same markers as me. I was really trying to have some patience with her, but I just didn't understand why she wanted to copy my every move. My patience wasn't going to get me very far. Then, on Wednesday, I wanted to make my brother JJ a bracelet, and Milana Hope wanted to make one too, with the same color beads. On Thursday, she had a matching headband and did her hair the same way I did. And on Friday, while I was dancing around, Milana Hope came up and started copying all my moves. That was my last straw. She wants to do everything I do. And though I do my best to keep it all in and not get mad at her, it's so annoying. I just can't take it anymore.
Woo, what a show. Her sister has a lot of energy to be copying her like that. I wonder if maybe she eats a lot of sugar. Or drinks coffee? No, she's got to be too young for coffee. Speaking of which... That's nice. Wait, did I just slurp inside my head? How peculiar. I'll have to write that one down. Is it possible for your brain to drink? Maybe Willander will have an answer for me. Anyways, back to the situation... Nora Grace looks pretty puzzled and perplexed. I'm familiar with this emotion, but it's not one I always love. Okay, Poppy, stick to your basics. We need more answers, so let's ask her some leading questions.
Is she making fun of you while copying you?
No.
Wrong motive. Interesting. It seems as though Nora Grace's sister doesn't have bad intentions.
Why do you think she copies you?
Well, I never really thought about it. Maybe she copies me because she wants to be like me.
Bingo.
Well, I guess she looks up to me. And if Milana wants to be like me, then I should try and be the best me that I can be. Miss Baker?
Detective Baker, please.
Yes?
Does the Bible say something about this?
Brilliant question. I'll have to do some research on that subject. Charles?
Hello? You've reached the audio message holder of I, Willinda Baker. Sorry, I can't come to the phone right now. I'm working on my latest scientific theory. It's a wonderful theory about Meg... Oh, my! My apologies. I must quickly go tend to something. But please leave a message at the sound of the beep. Toodaloo!
Willinda, darling, this is Poppy calling. It's all right that you didn't answer. I'll call Pastor Britt instead. But I did have a few questions about the possibilities of your brain drinking. Okay, cheerio. Let's call Pastor Britt instead. Hello, hello? Oh, hi, Poppy. Sorry, Detective Baker? What can I do for you? Why, yes, she is. It's for you, Pastor Britt.
Oh, thank you. Hello?
Hi there, Pastor Britt. I'm here with Noah Grace, and we were wondering if you could help us answer a question.
Of course. I'd love to help.
Wonderful. We're wondering if the Bible says anything about how we can be the best we can be.
It sure does. In the New Testament, it says that we should be imitators of Christ, which means we should try and be like Jesus.
You mean we should copy Jesus?
Something like that. We don't need to die on a cross or try to perform the same miracles as Jesus, but we can treat people the same way he treated them. To be kind, to love our neighbor, to pray, have patience, and lots of other really good stuff. The way to work on being our best or doing our best is to use what Jesus did here on earth as the example. I guess to be a good example to my sister and my brother and my friends and my family and, well, everyone, is to copy or imitate Jesus. That's right.
Brilliant. Thank you for helping us, Pastor Britt.
No problem. Talk to you later.
Good day. Thanks, Charles.
I only have one more question. How can we be like Jesus?
My thoughts exactly. Breaking news. We've just compiled a list of all the things we see of Jesus in the Bible, and surely there sure is a lot. For those of you who don't know, I'm Clayton Adams with AP Wonder News with your story today. This week, our field reporter, Abelia Fox, is how you say, off the field. Yes, if you remember from last time, she had a bit of a run-in with a flying garbage can lit. Mikey, am I reading this correctly? Okay. Whew, too bad. Anyways, due to said wild adventures, I have taken upon myself to slice down those many, many things about Jesus and compile them into 10 of my favorite traits of him. So, that's right, folks. It is time for
Clayton's Top 10.
Some of Jesus' character traits.
Well, howdy, and welcome back to
Clayton's Top 10.
Some of Jesus' character traits.
Alrighty, if y'all aren't familiar with how this thing goes down, I will be counting up 1 to 10 about my top 10 things that I like about Jesus in the Bible. Number 1, Jesus loves everybody. Yes, he loves the people on the other side of the world that you don't know. He loves your family that you do know. He loves everyone. Doesn't matter where they come from or where they've been, Jesus loves them. Alrighty, let's move on to number 2. Quick fire round, forgiven. Jesus is forgiven. You know, there once was a story in the Bible, and it's still there today. Some disciples asked him, if someone were to do something wrong, how many times should I forgive him? Is 7 enough? And Jesus said, no, not 7. Maybe more like 70 times 7. 70 times 7. I don't know how to do that math, but I'm sure that's quite a big number. Anyways, what Jesus is saying is we should forgive everybody all the time. If they ask for forgiveness, we should forgive them. And sometimes, even if they don't ask for forgiveness, we gotta forgive them. That's just what he asks us to do. Number 3. God is patient. You know, even if we do something wrong or forget to imitate him, He's forgiving, he's patient, he'll wait, he'll help to teach us. We don't have to worry. God is patient. And number four, Jesus is kind. Now tell me this, would you rather kindness or meanness? You know, I'm willing to bet that I'm not the only one that thinks that kindness feels better receiving than meanness. So, if we like kindness better, I think it'd be better to also be kind to others. And you know what? Jesus asked the same thing of us. He's kind in the Bible, and so we should probably be kind too. Alrighty now, I say we're just about halfway through. Water break. Okay, number five, faithful. You got it. Jesus is faithful. He is faithful to us. Guess what? He kept his promises when he said he was going to do something. He pulled through. He doesn't waver, but he sticks with us forever. Numero six, compassionate. You know, when Jesus saw someone struggling in the Bible, there were countless times where Jesus showed compassion and helped them. All right, let's move on to number seven. Jesus has self-control. You know, there's a wonderful story that we actually talked about a couple weeks ago. Do you remember the Easter story when Jesus was so calm when all the people were spreading lies about him? Well, guess what? He had self-control. Self-control. Yeah, he didn't get mad or upset. He just stood there and accepted it. He knew that God had it under control. So Jesus had self-control. I think if he can have self-control in that kind of situation, we can probably have self-control in other situations. Don't you think? Number eight, thankful. Jesus was thankful. He was thankful for the food he got, etc., etc. You know, manners can really take you a long way. Now, it's time for number nine, obedient. What? You might be thinking, oh, Clayton Adams, he is off his rocker. Jesus is Jesus. Why would he need to be obedient? Well, that's a very wonderful question. You know, he obeyed God and trusted him to come down to earth and die on a cross so that we could have a relationship with him. What an important time to be obedient, don't you think? And number 10, the very last one, but of course, not the least one. All right, joyful. Jesus was joyful. Though sometimes it feels like there's a lot of stuff going around that's difficult and challenging, and Jesus of all people went through some pretty challenging times. Jesus said that we should always be joyful, even when there's hard times. You got that, Clarence, even when there's hard times, to choose to have a good attitude. Alrighty, thank you very much for joining me here today on
Clayton's Top 10.
Some of Jesus' character traits.
But wait, before we go on, let's take a moment to see what y'all have been up to from throughout the weeks. Roll 'em. Alrighty, thanks for joining me here at AP Wonder News. I'm Clayton Adams. Ciao.
Hi guys, it's me, Milana Hope. I'm Nora Grace's little sister. You know, the other day I saw Nora Grace practicing a Bible verse, and Nora Grace showed me how it goes. She taught me the words and the action, so I thought that today I could do it with you guys. Sound good? Okay. Come on, let's do it together. It's found in 2 Corinthians 5, verse 17. And it goes like this. Anyone who belongs to Christ has become a new person. The old life is gone and the new life has begun. Good job. Okay, let's try it one more time all together. 2 Corinthians 5, verse 17. Anyone who belongs to Christ has become a new person. The old life is gone and the new life has begun. Good job. Thanks for coming by. See you later.
Hello, kids.
Hi, guys.
Welcome to Worship Time with Pastor Melinda and Asher. We're so glad you came to join us for some time to worship and sing to the Lord. So we're going to sing a song today called I Give You My Heart. Would love if you could sing along with us. You ready? Sunday. God bless you. Bye. Thank you so much for that amazing worship, Pastor Melinda.
Yeah.
We love having you on here to lead us in worship. I'm so blessed by that, and I was so blessed by our episode this week. What an amazing lesson for us to learn to be like Jesus, to be kind, to be compassionate, to care for people. And you know what's really amazing is that Jesus is full of grace. And so if we make a mistake or we mess up or we get a little bit mad, maybe like Nora Grace at our little brother or sister or one of our friends, Jesus forgives us and he says, come, let me forgive you and we can try again. I love Jesus and I love how he acted and how he encourages us to be like him.
Mm-hmm. And we have a special little something coming to you next week because next week, now we're giving you a little help here. Next week, his Mother's Day.
Mother's Day!
So we're gonna have an episode for you guys next week, but that means that the 2 weeks after, you guys won't see us. So you'll get 2 weeks on and 2 weeks off.
Well, that's it for today. If you want to send in your photos of what you're doing throughout the week, you can get your parents to send those to kids@youranchorpoint.com. See you guys next week.
Bye.